Very good afternoon to one and all. Please let me know whether my voice is audible and can you see my presentation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, I think shall we start now? In the last lecture, we have started the chapter number one, that is Introduction to Production Operation Management. Okay, and before that, we have taken the overview of the complete subject. What are the course outcome? What are the course objective? What is the content of complete subject? Then we have started the content of the chapter number one, and after that we started with the production. Okay, and we have understood the basic definition of production. Okay, and in that we come to know that it is a step-by-step process to convert the raw material into finished goods or services. Okay, so to complete this particular complete process, there are some chemical processes, some mechanical processes, and after that you are getting the complete finished product, okay, or your service you will get. Okay, so in that we have taken one example that iron ore exists in the nature, then it will be converted into a steel, okay, by a chemical process. Whatever the chemical processes are implemented for that steel conversion, okay, it will be happen and in steel plants, and then the wrought or we can say that composite steel we will get and that steel, according to the specification, will be used for making the bars, for making the pipes, for making the angles, or for making the channels. And at the end of the definition, we have commented that it is a value addition process. Okay, at each stage during the production, at each stage, the value is being added into that particular material or into that particular product. Okay, and also we have seen the definition given by the Edward Bufa, a process by which goods and services are created, or the process by which the utility is created. So services and goods are the subset of a utility. So we can say that the process by which utility is created. Okay, utility means what? Usefulness to the customer. Usefulness to the customer. Now, further in this lecture, we are going to understand what is meant by production management. Okay. And the production system. Okay, and in a production management, we try to understand the objectives of a production management, intermediate objective, final objectives, and in a production system, the different parameters or the different inputs, outputs, and the processing or intermediate stage we are going to understand in this particular production systems. Okay, so first point we are going to discuss now, that is nothing but production management. Now, in the last lecture, we have discussed the production. Okay, what is mean by production? Now, what is mean by management? Okay, production management. Before starting any production, okay, or before starting any production system, you should have a firm plan. Okay, first of all, you should have a firm plan. Then second thing is nothing but you need to organize the inputs according to your planning. Let us say you are working in a production department. So organization means what? Organizing the machines, organizing the material, organizing the manpower. Okay, so all three parts comes under the organization. Then after organization, we have to provide some set of instructions. Okay, let it be machine, let it be human being, we have to provide a set of instruction to the machines. Let us say if CNC VMC machine, the that instruction is should be in the form of a code. And if it's a human being or the worker which is working on a particular machine, then in that case the instructions, it should be communicated through papers, okay, on paper, or it should be communicated to that particular human being or that particular worker orally. Okay, and then once you have a firm plan, you have organized these things, man, machine, material, okay, and then you have given the set of instruction, then the next part comes under the controlling. Okay, controlling means what? Controlling of the quality, controlling of the production. Okay, controlling of the quality comes under that, whether that particular process, okay, particular process in the production system achieving the desired quality or not. Okay, desired quality or not. So for that reason, you are using a set of equipments like the gauges. Okay, for the quality tools, you are using the gauges, you are using the vernier calipers. Okay, then you are using the coordinate measuring machine. Okay, CMM machine. Then if you are checking the quality of molten metal, in that case you have to test the metallurgy of that particular molten metal. Okay, by testing the metallurgy in a metallurgical lab, you have to test that particular molten metal in the form of, or you can say that chemistry of that particular molten metal. So controlling is at every stage. Okay, controlling is at every stage of production system. Okay, controlling is at every stage of a production system. So production management is a combo pack of all these things. Okay, production management is a combo pack of all these things. So production management is a process of planning, organizing, directing, and controlling the activities of a production system, of a production system. So further in the slides, you come to know what is meant by production system. Okay, but now you have to understand what is meant by planning, organizing, then directing, and controlling. Okay, So I hope you understood what is meant by production management. So it is the combo pack of planning, organizing, directing, controlling activities. Okay. Now, once again, we are taking the reference of Edward Buffa. So he's one of the engineer who worked on this management systems, subjects. Okay, let us say management subjects. So Edward Buffa defines production management as production management deals with the decision making related to production process so that the resulting goods or services are produced according to specification in the amount and by the scheduled demand and out of minimum cost. Okay. So what points should we focus on this particular definition? Okay. So it is a decision making. Okay. It is a decision making process. Production management is a decision making thing in a production process. Okay. So in a production process, what is the final output? Your final output will be in the form of a goods or in the form of a service. Okay. Will be in the form of a service. If it is a tangible thing, then it will be form of a goods. If it is intangible thing, then it will be in the form of a service. Okay. Then that particular product should be produced the service should be provided in the desired specification. Okay. Specification means what? You can't produce anything without the specification. Let us say you want to produce one job on a CNC machine or on a lathe machine. Then there are some specification, diameter of that particular bar should be this much. Okay. Then here taper should be provided. Then here knurling should be provided. Okay. Then here drilling should be provided, and that drill size should be this much, the tool size should be this much. Okay, so like that the specifications are provided, and one should manage that particular specifications in the product so that we can achieve a desired quality. Okay, we can achieve the desired quality. Now while doing that particular thing, one should have eyes on the amount which we are spending on production. Okay, production of a specific component. Okay, while we are doing such a things related to the production, we should keep our eyes on the cost also. Because the cost is the major factor. If you produce that component and it is not in your reasonable price, okay, reasonable price of a product, then it will be more costlier than your competitor. Okay, than your competitor. So the cost is a major factor while selecting or taking any decision related to man, machine, material, information, and energy. Okay, so we can say that the production management is a decision making process related to the things which are conducted in a production system and which produce the goods and services. Okay, and that produce the goods and services should have the specific quality, and that should be produced in a desired range of money or desired cost. Okay, in the range of a desired cost. Okay, so for that purpose the production management is very much important. Okay, getting everyone? Is there any question, any doubt in the production management? Is there any question? No? Shall I move ahead? Now, what are the different objectives of a production management? Why production management is important? Okay. The objectives of a production management are segregated in two blocks. First one is final objectives, and second one is intermediate objectives. Okay. First one is the final objective, and second one is the intermediate objective. So, final objectives are the right quality, right quantity, right time, and right manufacturing cost. Okay, so to produce goods and services of a right quality, right quantity, and the right time at a right manufacturing cost. This is the objective of a production management. Okay, so what is meant by right quality? So what is the quality? Quality means what? Whatever the customer's needs are there, okay, whatever customer needs are there, all such needs should be put up in the product, okay, and fulfill the desires of a customer, okay, fulfill the requirements of a customer, okay. If your product is able to fulfill the requirements or a desires of a customer, then that particular having that particular product is having right quality, okay. Now the quality is also we can say that the quality is also related with the cost, okay. Quality, the word quality is also related with the cost, okay. For a particular cost, what should be the quality? And for lower cost, what should be the quality? For higher cost, what should be the quality? Here you can take the example of any car which is manufactured in India, okay. Let us say Maruti Suzuki, okay. The range is in between 5 lakh to 12 lakh, okay. I will say the range, okay. And the car which is manufactured by BMW company, Ferrari company, okay, Mercedes company, okay. Now the range of that particular cars will start from 30 lakhs and above, okay. So why there is a difference between these two different products? So because of its quality. How much quality is sufficient for 5 lakh to 12 lakh range? That much quality is deployed by the companies from which are situated in India. And what is the quality desired for 30 lakh to 1 crore or 1.5 crore car? That quality is deployed by BMW, Ferrari, Mercedes-Benz like companies, okay. So quality we can correlate with the cost also, okay. Quality also we can correlate with the cost also, but for a desired cost, for a particular cost range, the desired quality should be achieved, okay. Desired quality should be achieved. Now second objective of a production management is nothing but a right quantity, okay. Right quantity, what do you understand by considering this particular word, right quantity? Right quantity, what is mean by right quantity? Hello, please let me know whether my voice is audible. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that will be fine because I'm not getting any response from your side. So that, okay. So what you understand right quantity? Anybody? Right quantity? For that reason, I will explain this particular point. What is mean by right quantity? Consider there is a demand of 100 components in a 1 month. Okay. Means what? Your company will be sell off 100 components to your customer. Okay. Let it be your company is a small scale company. Your company is a medium scale company. Okay. And you are producing something, and you are providing that particular component for TVS Motors, for Tata Motors or Mahindra and Mahindra company, okay. Let us take this particular example, and there is a demand of 100 components for a particular month, okay, for a particular month, and you have produced 200 components, okay. You have produced 200 components. So in that case, what will happen? The 100 components will be acquired by your customer, but 100 components will be kept in an inventory, and your money or the company's money or the organization or institutional money will get blocked in that particular product. It will get blocked in that particular product, and it will be recovered when you get the next order from your customer. Okay, it will be recovered when you will get the next order from your customer. So up till that particular period, whatever the money is blocked, okay, apply the compound interest or a simple interest on that particular money, that will be your loss for that particular period, okay. That will be the loss for your company for that particular period, for the blocking of the company capital, okay, or the industry capital. Now this is the example of a right quantity. So you have to produce the component as per the demand, okay? And demand will come to you from the forecasting or from the order side, okay? So the next point or next objective is right time, okay? Right time is also important. Now I have given the example of your customer want 100 components in a month, okay? Similarly, your customer want 100 component in a month at the end of this particular month, okay? And you are unable to produce 100 component at the end of this particular month, okay? There are lots of reason in the industry to not produce or to not fulfill the requirement of a customer. What are that particular reasons? First one, I will say the absenteeism, okay? Major problems in the industry. Absenteeism is a major problem, okay? Failure of a machine is the second problem, okay? Or failure of a management or not procuring or ordering the desired quality raw material. Okay, there are a number of problems like this. So if the more absentee is there, then you are failed to organize the production, okay? Then your machine is failed, then equipment failed, then you cannot do anything. So you have to give time for the maintenance purpose, breakdown maintenance purpose. So that time will be lost, important production time will be lost for the maintenance, and you are behind the time, okay? Your production will be behind the time, okay? So this is the point. Then whatever the material, raw material required to produce the particular product will not reach to your company, okay? Will not reach to your company, or on one of the party you are dependent, and that particular party will not transfer the raw material to you. In that case also, if there is no raw material, then you can't produce the product, okay? So there are such a big problems in the industries, and for that purpose only we are there. We as a engineer are there to tackle this problem, and you should have a sufficient solution to tackle this particular problem and to reduce the production loss time, okay? Whatever the production time is lost due to this particular factors, you have to cope up that particular time, or you have to minimize that particular time, and you have to fulfill the customer requirement on time, okay? Customer requirement on time. So the objective of a production management is also you have to produce the product at a right quantity, at a right quality, and at a right time. The last important point of a final objective is nothing but a right manufacturing cost. As we have discussed that there are some processes for producing one component. There is a step-by-step processes to produce any particular component, okay? And before going for the production, you have decided that what will be the final cost of that particular product, or how much money you are going to spend, your organization going to spend to produce, let us say, 1 lakh quantity of particular product, okay? So that will be decided by the company or the costing engineer at the early stage only, okay? So whatever the cost decided before the manufacturing of that particular product, so there should not be large deviation in that particular cost, okay? If the cost will get reduced, that is no problem, but you will achieve the overhead cost, means what? Whatever the desired quantity beyond that desired cost, whatever the desired cost is there, beyond that you go for manufacturing of that particular component, and beyond that cost required for manufacturing of a particular product, then it will impact on a profit of a company, okay? It will be impact on a profit of a company, and your company will be a loss-making company. Your company will be loss-making company. So desired manufacturing cost is important, okay? Desired manufacturing cost is important, and there should not be a large deviation from the standard cost. There should not be large deviation from the standard cost, whatever considered before the production or pre-production, whatever cost we have decided, that should be achieved, or there should be a very small deviation in between desired cost and achievable cost. Okay, so now these are the final objectives of a production management. So what are the different intermediate objectives? Now these are the final objectives. How we are going to achieve this particular final objectives, that is also important. So what are the problems I have suggested initially for right quality, right quantity, right time, and right manufacturing cost. So these problems can be solved by using the intermediate objectives. Okay, so first one is nothing but machinery and equipment in organization point. Okay, here in the definition of production management, we have considered the organization, organizing. Okay, this is the one of the part of production management, that is nothing but organizing. Okay, so what is mean by organizing? Organizing the machines, organizing the human power or workers, organizing the material. Okay, so machinery and equipment. Let us say you want to produce one component and you have the order of that particular component, but you don't have the machines which will produce that particular component. So will it be okay for your industry? It will not be okay for your industry. Okay, right? It will not be okay for your industry, or it will be okay for industry? No. Obviously, your answer should be no. Because if you don't have a machine, you can't take a order from your customer. Okay, so initially you should have a sufficient number of machines and equipments to produce the component. Okay, and that machine should be in a well condition. Okay, there should not be any maintenance. If it is there, then you have to carry out before the production start of that particular product. Okay, then equipment, for the quality purpose you required some equipments, for another transportation purpose you required intermediate transportation, I'm saying internal transportation, for internal transportation of a material you required some equipments or machines. So that should be available in your industry. Okay, then materials, raw material is a major problem for the industries. Let us have already provided, if material is not available, then you will not achieve desired time, or you will not fulfill your customer demand on time. So the raw material should be available at a right time. Okay, and then and then only your right time objective, final objective, will be match up from that particular production system. Then manpower, okay, skillful manpower is more important, or requirement of the industry. So skill sets requirement, desired skill set manpower should be with the industry, and then only your production system will be run properly. And whatever the success of any production system or any industry is depends upon the manpower which is working at that particular location. Okay, so you will achieve the success if you have right manpower for the working purpose, and your industry will get failed if you don't have the right manpower. Okay, then supporting services. Which are the supporting services? Do you know? Let us say design department is a supporting service for the production system. Okay, production means what? Manufacturing, whatever CNC, BMC machines are there. If you have the foundry, then you can say that the foundry systems, whatever implemented in that particular industry, that will be the part of a production system. Now, the supporting services, the quality department is the supporting service for the production department. Then design department is the supporting service for the production department. Then finance services or of the finance department is there, which is the supporting service for the production department. Then purchase department is also there, which will be considered as a supporting department for the production systems or production department. So all these supporting services should function properly to achieve the desired goal. Okay, to achieve the desired goal. Okay, if you fail to procure or to purchase the right quality material at a right cost, or right quality raw material at a right cost, then you will fail in front of a right manufacturing cost and right quality. okay, that will not be achieved. This two objective will not be achieved. That is nothing but right quality and right manufacturing cost. If you fail to procure or to purchase the raw material at a specific quality or according to the specification and desired price. Okay, sometimes you know that the prices of materials are fluctuating on a daily basis. If you take the gold, okay, take the example of a gold, the prices of a gold are varying every day. Prices of, in a similar fashion, the prices of aluminium, prices of a copper, prices of a nickel, then prices of stainless steel, all the material prices are fluctuating on a daily basis. So one should procure the raw material at a desired cost, or which will be help the company to achieve a desired final cost of that particular product. Okay, so is there any problem? The production management, okay, objectives of a production and management, the final objectives are right quality, right quantity, right time, right manufacturing cost. And the intermediate objectives, when you fulfill the intermediate objectives, then only you will fulfill the final objectives. So intermediate objectives are machinery and equipment, materials, manpower, and supporting services. Is there any doubt in any question in this particular point, objectives of a production management? Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, getting everyone? So write down production management, write down the heading. Write up part is also important, because we are learning everything, but we are not keeping the data with us, so that we are failing to represent that particular data in the interviews and whenever required. Okay, so write down production management. Production management. Production management is a process of, production management is a process of, production management is a process of, planning, comma, organizing, comma, directing, and controlling and controlling the activities of production system, the activities of production system. Activities of the production system. Okay, the next, Edward Buffa defines production management. Edward Buffa defines production management as, in double inverted comma, production management deals with the decision making related to production processes so that so that the resulting goods or services so that the resulting goods or services resulting goods or services are produced according to specifications, comma, comma, in the amounts, and by the schedule demanded, and by the scheduled demanded, and out of minimum cost. Okay, and out of minimum cost. Okay, specification means quality. In the amount means quantity. Scheduled demanded means right time or at a particular time we have to dispatch. Then minimum cost, okay, that is nothing but right manufacturing cost. Okay, next is objectives of production management. Objectives of production management. In that you can write the objectives of the production management, the objective of production management, the objective of production management is to produce goods oblique services. Is to produce goods oblique services of right quality and quantity at the right time and right manufacturing cost at the right time and right manufacturing cost. Final objectives are first one, right quality. Final objectives are first one, right quality. Second one, right quantity. Third one, right time. And fourth one, right manufacturing cost. We will achieve these final objectives if you achieve the intermediate objectives. Okay, so intermediate objectives are first one, machinery and equipments. Second one, materials. Materials. Third one, manpower. And fourth one, supporting services. and supporting services. Final one is supporting services. Okay, so now we will move to the next point, that is nothing but a production system. Production system. So what is mean by production system? Let us understand this particular diagram, then you will come to know that what is meant by production system. Okay, for any production system to produce any service or a good, you required some inputs. Okay, and you have to convert that inputs into a final finished product or a goods, or you have to deliver your service to the customer. Okay, you have to do some processes on the inputs and you have to produce final good goods or products or services. Okay, so what are the inputs for any production system? Okay, so we know that the inputs for production system is men, material, machine, information, energy. Men, or we can say that the employees or the worker which will work in that particular department or in that particular industry. Okay, so human being is the most important part to produce the goods. Okay, then second one is materials. Raw material is required, okay, to produce the things. Third one is machines. Machines are required, okay, to process the things. So machines is also one kind of input. Then information. Information means what? You should have information to produce the thing. Let us say that information related to the metallurgy of a raw material. This is the information. Okay, you know that this is the specification I require in the material. Okay, so this is the information. I required the tools of this having this material. Okay, this is the information. Then the drawing of that particular component is one kind of a information, right? The drawing or whatever the design you have made to produce that component, and their dimensions which we have we can see in the drawing. Okay, that will be considered as the information. Okay, so information is one kind of a input. So information will be any kind. Okay, so which machine is required to produce the product, that is one kind of information. So without information we cannot go for the production. Okay, and to go for the production you required men, that is nothing but employees or a worker. Then second thing is materials are required on which we are doing the processings, and to do the processing you required the machines. Okay, and all this information all this will happen if you have the sufficient amount of information. And the last thing is nothing but energy. Energy will be in the form of electricity or fuels or any kind of energy that will be used at the production process for the foundries. Some foundries are or some furnaces are worked on fuels like oil fired furnaces. Okay, so in that case particular oil or fuel will be considered as the energy. Okay, machines are working on electricity, so electricity is one kind of energy. Okay, so the inputs for any production system is nothing but men, material, machines, information and energy. Now when we have all these inputs, okay, then we use this input to add the value in that particular product. Okay, value addition means what? We have already discussed, while doing any process, what things are used to do that particular process and how much amount is invested to do that particular process, and that amount will be interpreted in the product. So value addition will be there at each stage of a production system. Okay, value addition will be there at each stage of production system. Last lecture also I have given one example, that you want to do the turning of any job or any product, or you want to do the facing of any product, or you want to do the drilling of that particular product. So for the drilling purpose, for turning purpose, for the facing purpose, you are using machine, and machines are not having not come free of cost. So you have invested on the machine. So that machine value will also get added in that particular component. Then you are using the manpower to do that particular operation. So, and you are paying, or your industry is paying to the employee to perform the job in the industry. So you are paying for your employees also. So that money is also you are interpreting, or you are involving to do that particular task. Okay. Then you are consuming the electricity, or you are consuming the fuel. So amount of electricity consumed to produce or to complete that particular process. So that cost is also included in that particular product. Okay. So all such a cost, direct cost or indirect cost, are included to complete particular task. So during any process, or during the transformation phase from raw material from raw material to the finished good product, at each stage we are adding the value in that particular product. We are adding the value in that particular product. And if that particular product, that particular process will not add any value to the product, then we have to eliminate that particular process from the product. Okay. If any process will not add any value for the product, in that case we have to eliminate that particular process from the system, right? We have to eliminate that particular process from the system. Okay, obviously. Right, hai na? Okay, so transformation process. Okay, we are combining, organizing the inputs, and we are producing the goods. Okay, producing the goods. So output of the production system is in the form of a goods or a product, or will be in the form of a services. Now, this output goods or a services, we have to provide to the customer, right? We are producing something to deliver that product to the customer only. And after delivering the product to the customer will provide you a feedback, okay? About the product, it is good product, bad product, or this is not working properly. Okay, when you buy some product like a mobile phone, laptop, okay, you or any application also in your mobile related to the services, or related to your communication through your relatives by using the mobiles, and you are using the Jio card. One person is using the Jio card, and another person is using the Idea Vodafone card, and you are not able to listen properly from other side. So you directly say to you are always saying that phekun de tujha mobile, you are not your voice is not getting to me. Okay, so like that. So this is one kind of a feedback to the related to the company, and that particular person will complain to the industry, particular company, particular service provider, about the service, that your service is very bad, I'm not able to listen the things within the range also, and there is always a network problem. So this is the feedback of the company. So this is about the services. Related to goods, same as we have discussed, that you have purchased one mobile and it is not working properly, or there is some malfunctioning, or a heat problem, or display is not working properly. Then you go to the service center, and you provide the feedback to that particular service center, and service center will provide the feedback about the product to the company. So this is nothing but what? The feedback from the customer, your customer, and that will be measured. Okay, that will be measured, and it will impact on the quality of that particular product. So it will be measured, and it will be transferred to the industry. Okay, and accordingly, industry will make the changes in inputs. Okay, in inputs, whatever the main, if the main is or the skillful workers are not there, then the company will hire the skillful worker. If any material problem is there, then the company will change the material. Then if any machine problem is there, that machines are not able to produce the desired quality, then company will think about to change the machine or do the maintenance related to that particular machine. If any information lacuna is there, then company will think on that, brainstorm on that related to design, drawing, and the material selection for particular component, then whether it is problem of energy. So all these problems will be changed or slightly change will happen in the inputs according to the feedback provided by the customer. Okay, now second thing is now this feedback also going to the transformation or converging process. Okay, so related to machines, machines are the convergent processor. Okay, so if there is any problem related to the particular process, the drilling process, or is there any problem related to the tools, if the tools are wear out and then need to change that particular tools of a CNC VMC machine, or is there any problem related to the equipments, quality equipments, like the instruments I have mentioned, that the coordinate measuring machine, is there any problem in that? Is there any problem in the offset of a machine? So in that manner, this feedback goes to the conversion system also. Okay, now another thing is that this conversion system is also controlled. Okay, at each stage the quality of the product is checked. Okay, let us say you have produced one component in a CNC machine or VMC machine. Then after getting the component out of the machine, you have to check the quality of that particular product by using the gauges or vernier calipers or CMM machine. Okay, if it is okay, then you will transfer that particular product to the next process, or else you will get you will check the dimension, and if it will be wrong or that particular dimensions are not achieved as per the desired dimension, as per the specification given in the drawing or in that particular sheet, in that particular paper sheet on which the drawing is provided or the dimensions are provided. So if it will not match with that dimension, then you have to give the feedback, or that particular worker will provide the feedback to the engineer which is working in that particular department, and the engineer will check the machines, we can say the software checking will be there, the offset checking will be there, the program will be checked, is there any program problem, is there any offset problem in the CNC machine, or is there any problem in the VMC machine, whether the raw material is coming to the department, whether it is coming with the specification or not. So accordingly, this feedback is measured at every stage, and the controlling action will be happen on that particular feedback. Okay, if it is okay, the specifications are achieved as per the requirement, then no need to go for the changes in the system. Okay, and then the product will be accepted, or that particular process will be accepted, and the product will be transferred for the next process. Okay, and if there is any problem, then accordingly the actions will be taken, and the workers or employees which are working on that particular job, they try to resolve that particular problem. So this particular condition will be called as a controlling, will be called as a controlling. So while doing the value addition, the controlling process is always activated. Okay, controlling process is always activated, so that if any problem happen, that should be resolved at that particular condition only, or at that particular time only. Okay, so these feedbacks are very much important. So controlling action will be giving the feedback to the transformation process on a continuous basis, so that the desired quality product will be provided to the customer side. So the input, this production system consists of inputs, transformation or a conversion process, which will convert the inputs into output, and this particular outputs will be provided, or the outputs is in the form of a finished goods or a services, and that will be delivered to the customer. Customer will provide the feedback about the product, and that particular measured feedback is transferred once again to the input or a transformation process, and this transformation process is continuously controlled, and by controlling that transformation process, we're trying to achieve the desired quality of the product. Okay, so here you can see that feedback measurements takes at a various points in the transformation process. Control means what? The comparison of a feedback against the previous established standards to determine if corrective action is needed. Okay, to determine if corrective action is needed. Okay, not all the times the corrective action is needed. If it matches with the initial specification, then there will not be any problem. If it is not matches with the initial specifications, then in that case only we have to take the corrective actions. Okay, so production system is a part of an organization which produces the products. Okay, in every industry, in mechanical industry, you can say that the production industries are there. So where the products are produced, so whatever the system established in that particular industry to produce the goods, that system will be called as a production system. Okay, so it is a basic activity of all organizations, and all the other activities revolve around the production activity. The output of a production is the creation of a goods or a services which satisfy the needs of the customer. In some organization, the product is a physical good, while in other organization, it is in the form of a service. Okay, so production system will be a service or a, which will produce the service or goods. Okay, depends on the industry type. Okay, so is there any problem, any question in the production system? Is there any doubt, any question about the production system? Okay, let us draw this particular diagram. If you have any question, any doubt, please ask now only. Whether you are getting, what is meant by production system?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, great, great. Thank you. So draw this diagram. Meanwhile, you can put up your roll numbers in the chat box. Okay, no issue. While drawing the diagram, you can put up your roll numbers in the chat box. If you have any doubt, you can ask now only, so that your doubt will be clear now only. Or everyone, have you drawn the diagram? Okay, so write down some few points related to production system and then we will stop. Part of an organization which produces products. Part of an organization which produces products. Part of an organization which produces products. It is a part of organization which produces products. Next point. It is a basic activity of all organization. It is a basic activity of all organization. And all the other activities revolve around the production activity. All other activity revolve around production activity. Revolve around production activity. Next, the output of production is the creation of goods or services. The output of a production or production system is the creation of goods or services which satisfy the needs of the customer, which satisfy the needs of the customer, which satisfy the needs of a customer. In some organization, the product is a physical good, while in other, it is a service. In some organization, the product is a physical good, while in others, it is a service. Okay, so for today we will stop here only. Further points related to this chapter we will cover in the next lecture. If you have completed your write-up part, then you can put up your roll numbers in the chat box and you can join the next lecture. Roll number 80, 64, 51, 77. Please put up your roll numbers in the chat box and you can leave the meeting.